We, the women of the world. To be honest, it's up to us. We've got to step out of our passive roles, out of our subdominant roles, out of our victim roles. We have to start thinking the world is ours. We have to start taking our responsibility. We are more than half of the world's population. We have to, and we can, take our responsibility, our collective responsibility for designing the future. And there's so much to be done. I've got hundreds of ideas that haven't even been tried yet. Have we got pre- and post-natal and early childhood programs which are really based on inclusive, democratic, and a good gender justice analysis? And do we teach the potential mothers with their first babies what it means in those first few years, how things are dealt with, how the traditional child raising patterns can be changed? Do we do the same in our own social environments, our families, our clubs, our civil society, our workplaces? Our workplaces geared to allowing women as well as men to take their share of parenting? Our cities designed for people and not for consumption? Transforming the value chain in agriculture. Go right back to where does this piece of food come from? And who has made the profit on the way? If you've ever done that, I've done it quite often. If you check what a woman gets plucking the grapes for the glass of wine we're drinking, it's shocking. I've said for ages that any product that we wear or use or eat usually only has about 1% of production in there. And maybe that's an exaggeration, but nobody's ever argued with me. But if that's true, then 99% is made on the way through all the kinds of advertisements and all the other things encouraging us to buy the wrong thing. Maybe one of the most important things we women of the world, we citizens of the world, we the majority of the world, maybe one of the most important things is transform our basic belief of what a good politician should be. A good politician and a good leader, it's a leader anyway really, but particularly politicians, so interesting. We have become used to the fact that a politician is one who bluffs, who debates well, and who doesn't keep his promises. Now what kind of example of leadership is that? Wouldn't it be nice if we have politicians who might not debate or talk so well, but who actually do what they say? And might be a man or a woman. And funny enough, if you compare this leader, Gordon Brown, to the last leader in England, it's a case in point. Because there's a lot to be said against Gordon Brown, but he's more concerned with poverty than his predecessor. So, what are we doing? What are we expecting from leadership? Bluff and, excuse my New Zealand language, bullshit. I would like some values in the leadership. And we're looking into this. Couldn't we actually say, when the Millennium Goals have been promised and promised and promised again, can we take our leaders to court on breach of contract? It's amazing. When I make a verbal agreement with any of you, you can go and get some legal advice and you can hold me to it. And we have become used to letting our politicians just get away with everything. And I won't say murder, but sometimes when you're talking poverty, it is murder. It's unnecessary death, particularly women. So what are we waiting for? Our sisters in the Global South are dying in increasing numbers with the crisis increasingly. We are the able, intelligent, strong women of the North. Let's get on with it. But our leaders in the UN General Assembly collectively scrapped the word transformation. We should not allow that. The joke in the corridors of the United Nations that particular week was, if people were cars, the bailout packages would be coming. Now that is not funny. So it's up to us. And it's not just women, there are plenty of men in my experience who understand, who are true allies, who are organizing the tipping point in their own surroundings, and who are wanting to swing the political reality too. So let's work towards a different world. And access to water for every woman in the world is as good an indicator as any. So to conclude, I will rewrite my own dismal chant that I started with in this speech. And the rewritten chant is, what can you do? There's so much you can do, see. Where we are born should be the same for you and me. What can I do? There's so much more to do, see. We cannot live without justice, you and me. And if I really can get you revolutionary and you're ever going out in the streets again and you're demonstrating, surely the one chant you must all use is water, sanitation, food, health, education. Thank you very much.